I've listened to so much crap in the last 2 weeks.
Hey, buddy.
You know, you hear all that crap, but I understood that that crap was going to come with the territory.
Hey, buddy.
But I'll live with the crap.
Buddy.
And I feel very good.
He's a disgruntled Scottish guard known for his lethal temper and his unusual eating habits. He weighs a metric ton. His name, Fat Bastard.
One of the things, Mike, that's been pointed out over the course of today and last night after the game is that you seem resigned to the fate after the game, that there wasn't much fire in you, and you sort of stood up before the media and said, well, you know, this is the way it is. Are you resigned to this fate?
Well, you're the same guy that wrote about me when I did have the fire, that was the wrong thing to do. So who are you crapping?
Well, I'm just
don't
asking.
Don't crap me. No.
Tell me lies. Tell me sweet little
It is indeed time for our signature segment, Boers and Bernstein, Chicago Sports Radio 670 The Score. And remember, limited to something someone said, not something someone did. And I promise you, if you ramble on,
you're where are you going with going that shotgun?
That's right. You're not going to reach the finish, so don't do that.
We will begin with Gary in Evanston on The Score.
Hi, guys. The Cartwrights loved San Francisco.
Well, sure they did.
Are they gay?
No doubt about that.
But Armo Dove's late wife was in a Bonanza episode, so who do I root for on Sunday? Anyway, the Cartwrights were great friends of Native Americans. This crap is for Kansas City.
All right.
Public editor Derek Donovan, who was recently quoted in an Eric Zorn column as saying last fall that his paper would no longer publish the word Redskins because it was, quote, inconceivable that the NFL still allows such a patently offensive name and mascot to represent the league. Well, of course, Donovan's right about that, but he did not say one word about the name of his own city's NFL team, the Chiefs, who just happened to play in Arrowhead Stadium and who still use a horse named War Paint to celebrate their rare touchdowns while their fans do the tomahawk chop. Derek Donovan, you hypocrite. Who are you crapping?
Boy, that covered the spectrum for me right there. That's my Gary fix.
Pete Hawk says, this crap goes out to Anaheim Ducks coach Bruce Boudreau. Assessing rookie goaltender Victor Fast's first career win in a shootout last Saturday, Boudreau said he was as calm as a cucumber. Coach, I can't really dispute that cucumbers are, in fact, calm. They are inanimate, after all, setting aside Veggie Tales and obscure 1950s low-budget horror movies, and thus the very definition of peaceful and serene. Whoa. But I think you meant cool as a cucumber. Bruce Boudreau, you crapping.
Love that. Outstanding.
Claude and Wilmette, you're on The Score.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
The dodo's extinction was caused by humanity. However, there isn't a single documented case of a Bob ever killing one of those dim-witted birds. Texas's ultimate reprobate, Lance Armstrong, stated days before his confessional slash ersatz apology to Oprah that he would answer questions directly, honestly, and candidly. However, when Oprah brought up his admission of using a myriad of PEDs that was witnessed by former teammate and friend Frankie Adreu and others in a hospital, his response was, I'm not going to take that one on. I'm laying down on that one. Lance Armstrong, you tyrannical turd, who are you crapping?
Oh, that's always good. Don in Jacksonville writes, in a commercial for a new phone, one Gwen Stefani states that the creative process never stops and songwriting is so hard. Really, Gwen? Is it? How many sleepless nights did you spend creating such lyrical brilliance as This Is Bananas, B-A-N-A-N-A-N-A-S? And please explain the grueling process that spawned the transcendent hey, baby, hey, boys say, girls say, hey, baby, hey. Yeah, you're right. It's tough to generate nonsensical, meaningless drivel. If it were easy, toddlers would do it. Oh, Wait, I'm confident I speak for the rest of humanity when I say I anxiously await the day you no longer holla back, girl. Who you crapping? Didn't think we'd get one for Gwen.
I didn't either. No, that's
Southside, Rocco's on the score. Rocco!
Hey, how you doing, Margie?
Good, Rocco.
Okay, hey, this is for Phil Rogers. Last week, Jermaine dies on a radio, a TV show, and Phil Rogers asked him, this is our MVP from a World Series, our only one. Phil Rogers asked him the burning question, in your retirement, playing on all those golf courses in Arizona, what do you think of the trade of Upton to Atlanta? JD says, well, since I don't live in Arizona, I guess that's a good trade for Atlanta. Phil Rogers, if you don't read your own paper, read the other one. Who you crapping?
Upcoming foul, says defense attorney Robert Rataka, who, after successfully keeping Mark Ditka out of jail on a felony DUI charge, said, it's kind of a sad story in his young life. He just got caught up in the times.
Yeah, I love this, yeah.
Not that I normally count such things, but this is Mark's fourth DUI arrest, tying him with brother Michael for the family lead. Nobody's gone to jail yet, so big shout-out to the Lake County State's Attorney's Office for getting rolled, again, by the family's lawyers on a plea bargain that will before long have Mark free to drive the streets of my community. But when someone gets hurt, it won't be your fault, State's Attorney, nor, it turns out, will it be Mark's fault. Because according to Mr. Rataka, it's these damn times, an era of wild suburban debauchery ensnaring poor young Mark, making him drink, forcing him to get behind the wheel. Drunk drivers don't kill people. The Times do. Or wait, maybe he meant Mark was caught up in the New York Times. Nah, probably not. Mr. Rataka, over 250 families in Illinois lost a loved one to drunk driving last year. Yep. And people like you blaming our times is part of the problem. Nothing is inevitable. People have free will, and they can make choices. Tell that to your client, Robert Rataka. Who you crapping?
I thought the same thing.
Here is Northside Pimp. He's on Who You Crapping on the score.
Pimp!
What's happening, players? Welcome to my show.
Well, thanks for having us.
No, anytime. You guys are welcome. This crap is the obvious one, but it's got to be done. That Tuiasa Sopo guy who comes out and admits some romantic interest in Manti Te'o, and when asked if he was gay, his final response was, I'm kind of confused. Let me make it easy for you. If your fantasies involve more than one male organ, you gay as hell. Confuse my ass. Tuiasa Sopo, you gay-ass bitch. Who you crapping? That's why he's gay.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Well, we're going to have you. We're going to enter you in that program, Pimp.
Yep, we're going to get setting you up. Schmutzy says, thank God we have people like Jim Rome to point out how ridiculous Chris Culliver's remarks on gays in the locker room are. In a CBS Sports Minute today, Rome went to great lengths to rebuke Culliver, saying there's no place for bigots in an NFL locker room. Yeah, right, Jim. There's no room for that sort of thing in an NFL locker room. It's nobody's place to question the masculinity of another man. Who cares if a guy has testosterone dripping from every pore? Who cares if a guy is slightly less than a 1940s stereotypical manly man? Who cares if a guy doesn't fit the rugged NFL player mold, like, say, former Saints quarterback Jim Everett? Just imagine how Everett would have responded if someone had repeatedly bowdlerized his name during a 1994 interview and compared him to female tennis player Chris Everett.
Oh, that's nice, Schmutz. That's
Jim
nice.
Rome, who you crapping?
That's nice.
Wow. Yeah, there's a lot of good out there. Mm-hmm. Here's a double crap from Lene Kakua's bachelorette party.
Well, this ought to be something.
It goes out to Reggie Evans and Gerald Wallace of the Brooklyn Nets. Wednesday, Reggie commented on the Miami Heat's recent championship, saying it doesn't prove nothing. That was a lockout season. Taking aim at 2012 NBA Finals MVP LeBron James, he said, our team is defending the Miami Heat. If our team has to defend one person, LeBron isn't going to score nothing. Well, I guess LeBron had a quiet night, scoring 24 points, grabbing 9 rebounds, and handing out 7 assists. Then after the 20-point loss last night, Gerald Wallace replies to the question, if the Heat are 20 points better than the Nets, with, no, I don't think so. I don't think they're that much better. I don't think they're 20 points better than us. Well, let's look at the 3 games this season between the Nets and the Heat. You lost by a combined 63 points. So, some quick grade school math lets us conclude that the Nets have lost by an average of 21 points per game. The closest of these was 13. Reggie, you played 20 minutes and scored 0 points. Gerald, you played 29 minutes and scored 6 points. Between both of you, you needed 10 more points to make Wallace's statement a fact. Unfortunately, on the season, Wallace's 9 per game and Evans's 3.2 just wouldn't cut it. So I get you're trying to rile your team up and get in the heads of the Heat. If you're going to do it, back up your smack talk where it matters, on the court. Reggie Evans, Gerald Wallace, who you crapping?
Boy, that was quite something. And LeBron played very, very little in the fourth quarter because he destroyed them in the third quarter. It really was him.
Z is in his car. He's on Who You Crapping on the Score.
Hey, hi, guys. This is my first crap.
Good luck with your first crap.
Yeah, this crap goes out to Herm Edwards, who on a morning talk show said that he gave wide words of wisdom to Alex Smith's career. He said that life is a circle. It starts in the beginning and ends in the end. Well, Herm, last time I checked, we wasn't born at 20 years old, pushed out of our mother's crotch. So, Herm, please keep your Confucius wise words of wisdom to yourself. And, Herm, who are you crapping?
I know what he meant.
I know what he meant, too. Right. Yeah, His spirit was in the right place.
I was going to say that that's kind of a line and not a circle.
But I was lost in the crotch thing. No. Yeah, all right, that's what we're in the middle of, our signature segment. Who you crapping? We always say, jump on in, 312-644-6767. Come out and play. Chicago Sports Radio 670. The Score. Who you crapping? We are in the midst of Who You Crappin', Boers of Bernstein, Chicago Sports Radio 670 to Score. And as always, I am looking for that big finish.
Here's Quad Cities Pat. How about a big crapper instead?
He said, well, we got that. So we do.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Good.
Glad you're back, Terry. This crap goes out to Gail Trotter, a senior fellow at the Independent Women's Forum and gun enthusiast. Wednesday, in a Senate hearing about gun control, she stated, an assault weapon in the hands of a young woman defending her babies in the home becomes a defense weapon, and the peace of mind she has knowing that she has a scary-looking gun gives her more courage when she's fighting hardened, violent criminals. This is laughably over the top on its face, but it goes beyond the hyperbolic pale when you consider that Ms. Trotter is also an outspoken opponent of the Violence Against Women Act. Writing in 2012, she called the VAWA reckless demagoguery that infringes on the rights of men who are falsely accused of domestic battery. Apparently, blowing a man away with a Bushmaster 223 doesn't infringe on his rights. Just to be clear, an act that aims to reduce and prevent violence is reckless demagoguery, but suggesting that we should arm women with assault weapons isn't? While you're limbering up your brain for all the mental flip-flops, please, Gail, tell us. Who you crapping?
Thank you, Pat. Hendo in Rockford says this goes out to the coach. Wednesday night, he was asked his opinion of Jim Harbaugh, and after he fluffed up Harbaugh, they showed a clip from that game October 4th, 1992 against the Vikings, where Ditka goes crazy on Harbaugh. When asked why he was so upset with Harbaugh, he said, I called a run for Peyton, and he audibled. Don't get me wrong. I'd love to see video of some former Bear greats. But Walter Payton retired in 1987. Coach, he didn't go riding off into the sunset with you at the end of the year. So, Mike Ditka, who you crapping? Think about that. He didn't know that. And our old buddy Scott in Davenport said, Mully and Hanley, this morning we're talking with Damon Bruce, a San Francisco sports radio guy. And he got three of these in one segment. One, he referenced the senator who said he knew obscenity when he saw it. It wasn't a senator. It was a Supreme Court justice. It was Potter Stewart in the 1964 case Jacobellis versus Ohio. To their credit, Mully and Hanley corrected this. He referenced Jay Cutler as the best Bears quarterback since Y.A. Tittle. who played for the Bears. Mully and Hanley corrected this after the interview. And he referred to the Greek god Sisyphus, who was sentenced to eternally push a boulder up a hill, only to watch it roll back down. Sisyphus was not a god, merely a king. We all make mistakes, but rarely 3 in 5 minutes. Damon Bruce, who you crapping?
Start listening to the show.
Yeah, I think you could find it if you wanted.
Sure. Damon Bruce, absolutely.
Northwest Side John is on the Score. Hi, John.
Hi, guys. My first crap also.
Good luck with your first crap.
This crap goes out to the WGN Morning News Brain Trust that is Robin Baumgarten, who on Monday, January 21st at 6:32 a.m. said, and I quote, President Obama will be sworn in for his second term in office after today's inauguration. Well, this is wrong on two counts, because first of all, one would get sworn in during the inauguration, hence the purpose for having an inauguration. But more importantly, this term, this time around, the actual swearing in occurred the day before, on Sunday the 20th, as it is constitutionally mandated. So Baumgarten once again proved the old adage that the only reason to watch anybody's morning TV news show is to find out what the weather is. Robin Baumgarten, who you crapping?
Nicely done.
Yeah, that's it.
Iranian space monkey shaver says this goes out to professional snowmobiler Jimmy Fejes. I think it's pronounced that way.
I have no idea.
Who on the heels of the tragic crash that killed fellow snowmobiler Caleb Moore said this, "We are modern-day explorers. There are no new places in the world to see and discover, so you have to try to create new things. That's who everybody is." What are you exploring, Jimmy? Since when did coming up with new ways to flip a 500-pound piece of machinery while in the air and landing safely turned you into an explorer? The concept of what you do has been done many times before. Evel Knievel? Robbie Knievel? The guys who strap helmets on their heads and get launched out of cannons at the circus? Olympic diving? It takes cojones to do flips in 180s and 360s and 720s and whatever else is done, but don't try to convince anybody that you're doing anything innovative just because you decided to do it while on a snowmobile. Trick snowmobiling is dangerous. That's the draw of the competition. Jimmy, who you crapping?
Jimmy!
John in Lake Geneva is on the score.
I love my suit. On Monday morning, Mulligan was extorting the value of young players going to the Pro Bowl, and in his best John Gruden said, a guy like Henry Melton could get a lot from spending a week with a guy like Julius Peppers. Okay. While Hawaii is a spectacular place for couples to learn about each other in Hawaii, maybe he could just walk down to Julius's locker next year and get some tips. So, Mike Mulligan, who are you crapping?
Thank you, John. Adam in Buffalo Grove writes, CHI, or Catholic Health Initiatives, is an organization operating under the principles of the church. The mission, according to promotional literature, is to nurture the healing ministry of the church and be guided by fidelity to the gospel. What does it mean? It means, amongst other things, that CHI follows rules established by the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops in regards to birth control and abortions. That is to say, they forbid it. Quote, the church witnesses to the sanctity of life from the moment of conception until death, their directives state. The church's defense of life encompasses the unborn. Well, that's all well and good, so long as you ascribe to their political viewpoints on the sanctity of human life. But clearly not everyone agrees with what Catholic Initiatives institutes in its hospitals, most prominently Catholic Health Initiatives. In 2006, Lori Stodgehill entered the emergency room at St. Thomas More Hospital, a subsidiary of CHI, vomiting and short of breath. She died in the emergency room without having seen a doctor an hour later. Her unborn twin sons died with her. Her husband, Jeremy Stodgehill, sued the hospital for malpractice in the deaths of all three. CHI's defense, quote, under Colorado law, a fetus is not a person. Catholic Health Initiatives lawyers wrote, quote, and plaintiff's claims for wrongful death must therefore be dismissed. The courts found in their favor. But you can't argue that life begins at conception and deny people completely legal medical procedures because they go against your beliefs and then deny those beliefs when it's most legally convenient. That makes you a hypocrite. Although if you're aiming to emulate the Catholic Church, it's about right. Catholic Health Initiatives, who you crappin'? Please check your manometer.
Oh, man. Well, you know, it's been a while, so it is absolutely ready to burst. And I stayed close on this one. I can't go too far, I'm told.
Mantino.
Nope, Manhattan. But very, very close.
All right, Bill Walton's buck teeth will close out who you're crapping on the score.
Whenever I have no one to crap on Thursday at 5:15, Doug Gottlieb always gives me ammo, so I'm thankful for him. Today, he spent his 1 minute talking about how we've done a lot of growing when it comes to gay athletes, was his point. This is the 92nd birthday of Jackie Robinson. And I guarantee you, Doug, there have been gay men in professional locker rooms longer than there have been black men in professional locker rooms. We have made no progress because you're still asking questions about what it's like to have a gay teammate. Doug, once there's an openly gay athlete in a locker room, we'll have done some growing. Once it's not a story anymore, we'll have done some growing. But until then, use your minute to make a difference instead of making a big pile of crap. Doug Gottlieb, who you crapping?
You make hey, buddy. With the things you say. Oh, maybe Doug Gottlieb. You were having hey, all day. You must have
thought that we were napping. Hey, I'm gay.
Hey, buddy. Hey.
Who you crapping?
Hey, Doug.